So if you have somebody, go ahead and use your phone for a couple minutes and tell them what to do, and they can be here with us in mind tonight. Again, to thank all the people, as my notes have said it, the impossible, because I'm not a loner. I'm a guy that has had people helping me do everything, and I love it that way. Especially the most important person, my wife, of course, has helped me get through all of this, so thank you. We're blessed to have our two sons with us tonight from New York and from the Portland area, and family and granddaughter and daughter-in-law. So thank you for, and again, I don't start down the road because so many of you have an identification with me and with the band and with everything. So anyway, thank you. There are a couple of people that I couldn't help, though, that I have to solicit a response from you. The guy that's been doing our graphic arts for 20-some years now, all his idea, and he's the guy that says it's the end of an era. This is the guy who's designed all of our graphic art, our programs and our posters. Mr. Clint Cedar, would you please stand and be recognized by everybody? A brilliant guy. Brilliant. And of course, tonight we're blessed to have my Rotarian friends with us helping ushering, so we made sure that everybody had a seat. So thanks to Rotary people, and I know, Judy, you'll want me to tell you that they need to be at Rotary in the morning, no matter what. I want to thank John Hopperstadt, who is here with Channel 13, another former student who says that the interview he's doing and some of the shooting will be on tonight's news and tomorrow morning also. So they've been very faithful to us and to me, my career. So again, thanks, John, thanks to Channel 13. Okay, it's music time. I can't spend any more time thanking people because that's all we would get done. So I want to turn it over to the voice of the Shoreline Concert Band, my great friend and great voice. Please welcome David DeLappi.
By starting with our host group. So please give a warm welcome for the Shoreline Concert Band. And to conduct the first piece this evening is the assistant conductor. Please welcome to the podium, Mr. Chris Davis. Back into musical history to present the Grande Marcia Italiana. Julius Fucik wrote over 400 marches, but this is the granddaddy of them all.
Thank you.
1994, Ken Noreen and Brent Degenhardt both left Shorecrest High School and continued on to high learning opportunities. Ken came here to Shoreline Community College as band director, and Brent went to the University of Washington to study. Well, on this special night, we bring their paths together again. Please welcome to the stage soloist Brent Degenhardt and the director-conductor of the Shoreline Concert Band, Mr. Ken Noreen. Selected is the Concertino for Clarinet. The composer, Carl Maria Friedrich Ernst von Weber, is known as the first significant composer of the Romantic school. All of his works are played today and thought of as occupying important places in the field of musical repertoire.
Thank you.
Shoreline Concert Band concludes this portion of the program playing Ken Noreen's favorite Alfred Reed band work. Now, Mr. Reed said this about his piece, quote, "When the hounds of spring are on winter's traces," the opening line of a 19th century poem, "is a magical picture of young love in springtime and thus forms the basis for the present musical setting in a traditional three-part overture form," end quote. This band work was inspired by the poem of the same name written in 1865 and made the author Algernon Swinburne literally an overnight success. Mr. Reed's wonderful arrangement is also here to stay and be played forever.
Thank you.
now please welcome back to the podium, Mr. Ken Noreen. We put out an invitation to people who might want to be here and participate in an end-of-era concert with Ken. In front of you are about 60 or so people who decided to make the effort. Every one of these people, I'm sure, has a story to tell about being in band someplace along their musical path with Ken. I've heard some great stories backstage. One of them here actually had Ken when he was in grade school. Ken! Whoa! But there are many stories we can go on forever, but no, I'd rather hear the music. But that really did bother my mind.
Well, it's legal, right?
I get one shot, Ken. I get one shot. I want to thank Alec Vilmar for putting this together, getting the sheet music out, and now playing in the groove. All right, Ken has selected three pieces that reflect the end of era theme. First, Procession of Nobles by Rimsky-Korsakov. This is the cortege from the opera ballet, The Golden Conqueror, composed in 1868. The opera ballet was not a success, but this piece of music became part of a suite of five numbers that has survived time and is played quite often.
Thank you.
We now turn to one of this country's best musical writers. Frank Ticheli says this work was inspired by the freedom and beauty of the folk song melody and by the natural images evoked by the words, especially the images of a river. Ticheli says, and I quote, "I was less concerned with the sounds of a rolling river than with its life-affirming energy. Sometimes the accompaniment flows quietly under the melody. Other times it breathes alongside it." End quote. Relax and discover the work's mood ranges from quiet reflections through growing optimism to profound exaltations in Shenandoah.
Thank you.
our grand finale tonight, we are going to perform the stirring 1812 Overture. Normally, many weeks and months go into preparation of performing this piece, but tonight, we're going to see what happens after only two short rehearsals.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, that rousing piece does not conclude our concert tonight. Oh, no, Ken, you can't sneak out the back door again. At this time, I would like to invite, I don't know where he went to, but Professor Jim Salzman, where did you disappear to?
Well, I don't want to wax on, it's been a long concert, but I do want to say that Ken has told me for years and years and years, Timmy will tell me when I don't have it anymore, right? You'll let me know. Ken has still got it. And a special song from an institution that Ken loves dearly. Dr. McDavid.
Thank you.